The Earth has one natural satellite, the Moon. Like Mercury, the Moon has many craters produced by meteorite impacts billions of years ago. The dark plains are due to particularly large impacts that produced huge pits, which then filled with molten lava from the Moon's core. In contrast to the Earth, which is a living planet, the Moon is a dead, dry, colorless world with no atmosphere and hence no erosion. Consequently, its surface has remained mostly unchanged for billions of years.
During its 16 months around our Moon, Europe's Smart One orbiter has taken some of the highest resolution pictures ever obtained of its surface. The satellite's AMI miniature camera has sent back some 20,000 views. The whole Moon has been mapped with resolutions from 40 meters in the south to 200 meters over the North Pole. Valuable information for future missions. Features that predominate are the millions of craters, large and small, that pockmark the surface, evidence of the regular onslaught of meteorites throughout the ages. Lunar impact flashes during Leonid's meteor shower were first reported by Spanish astronomers in 1999. In May this year, a 10-inch NASA telescope was able by chance to record the impact flash of such a meteorite. 4 months later, the Smart One satellite has made its own mark on the Moon, with a precisely controlled and spectacular finale to its mission. A network of ground stations, optical and radio telescopes was ready to observe the impact site, the Lake of Excellence in a cratered highland area at a mid-southern latitude on the lunar near side. Since this exceptional crash scene investigation began, first analyses indicate that the satellite hit the Moon on the ascending slope of a mountain, about 1.2 kilometers high, above the plain of the Lake of Excellence.
If humans are to live on the Moon or even Mars one day, there is still a lot of work to be done. With this in mind, ESA is planning a new mission, landing an unmanned spacecraft near the Moon's South Pole, a region full of dangerous boulders and high ridges, but a possible location for future human explorers, because of almost continuous sunlight and potential access to water ice.
The next step is the Moon. The Moon being reachable in 2-3 days from the Earth, allowing us to put together a lot of technologies and a lot of experiments preparing for the human exploration of the Moon, and therefore as a step for the human exploration of Mars.
A study contract was recently awarded to the European industry to further develop this mission, which is part of an international framework. To reach the surface safely, the lander must precisely navigate its way to a mountain peak or crater rim, carefully avoiding boulders and steep slopes before gently setting down and starting to collect much-needed data. There are many issues that must be investigated for the long-term exploration of the solar system. In this, the lunar lander plays a small but crucial part before we can make another giant leap for mankind. The goal, then, is to launch the lander in 2018.